Well, hi there, and welcome to our Sunday hymn time. This week has been a real trip down memory lane for me. Earlier in the week, I was in my hometown of Hamilton, Ontario, Canada. Yep, up on the mountain, as they say. And had a chance to be with some folks that I haven't seen in, 50 years. Yeah, back to grade school. And what a great day we had, just reminiscing. It was a fun day. Speaking of fun days, I had an opportunity to have some coffee with my old friend David Illman. Now, some of you folks will know Pastor David, and he's almost 84 now, but the overruling passion in his life is to tell people the good news of the gospel of Jesus Christ. And if David were here right now, he would ask every one of us, hey, how's your relationship with Jesus? Now, since David isn't here, we'll do this song, which kind of asks the same kind of question. Now, speaking of reminiscing, this song goes back to the year I was born. Okay, 1956. Yeah, don't do the math in your head for too long. Anyway, here we go. Now, it's in that difficult E chord that I was telling you about a while back. Well, my friend Evan Snyder, he said, oh, you should sing more in the E chord. Well, bless his heart. But, you know, as you know, I mentioned it had that difficult B seventh. But this song also has a C sharp minor, an F sharp seventh, and a G sharp seventh. Well, anyway, life on the edge. Here we go. Now, as I mentioned, David would ask you the question this song is asking. Hey, how long has it been since you talked with the Lord? How long has it been since you talked with the Lord and told him your heart's hidden secret? How long since you prayed? How long since you stayed on your knees till the light shone through? How long has it been since your mind felt at ease? And how long since your heart knew no burden? Can you call him your friend? How long has it been since you knew that he cared for you? How long has it been since you knelt by your bed and prayed to the Lord up in heaven? How long since you knew that he'd answer you and would keep you the long night through? How long has it been since you woke with the dawn and felt that this day is worth the living? Can you call him your friend? How long has it been since you knew that he cared for you? How long has it been? Hey, maybe, in some cases, maybe it's been, maybe it's never happened. I don't know. But I was thinking, thinking about my good friend, Pastor David. Boy, he'd want me to share this verse with you. They call it the most famous verse in the Bible. John 3:16. For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have eternal life. For God did not send his Son into the world to condemn the world, but to save the world through him. Whoever believes in him is not condemned. But whoever does not believe, that person stands condemned already, because they have not believed in the name of God's one and only Son. This is the verdict, said Jesus. Light has come into the world, but people love darkness instead of light. I hope that's not you. Oh, I understand there's a great attraction to some of those things that we acquaint as being, well, not healthy for us, part of the darkness and not the light. I get it. It's in every single one of us. But I hope that you will reach out and talk to him and ask him. Just say, Lord Jesus, I admit, I'm a sinner. You know, Pat's been reminiscing about some of the years he's been here. I think about some of my years. And I need you in my life. And so just tell him. Tell him I believe that you sent your son who died on the cross and rose again for my sins to give me the gift of eternal life. I invite you, Lord Jesus, to come be my Lord and Savior. And then just begin to walk with him. And you know, some of you folks could do a much better job even than some of us in the church right now. Yes, go live your life in a way that a Christian should really live. We could all use more and more examples of those. All right, John 3:16. We got any baseball fans out there? Hey, you look at this. This baseball was handmade at the Waterloo Museum. Yeah, got one of these. And do you remember back in, I think it was the 1980s, right? Right there behind the batter, someone would be holding up this sign. John 3:16. That's the verse. That's what it was. May you live that. God bless you.